One of the most important books in the history of science was On the Revolutions of the Heavenly Orbs, De Revolutionibus, published in 1543 by Nicholas Copernicus. In this book, Copernicus switched the positions of the sun and the earth, hurling the earth out into the heavens and putting the sun like the lamp in the center of a temple. History is about stories, and what many people don't realize is that science is a story also. When we're in the presence of these rare books, we are in the presence of the people who crafted them, the people who poured their lives into writing them, who changed the future, who created our past. We're in the presence of all the generations who have preserved them. When we see multiple bindings on the same book, where the original binding might have been older than the original book, it awakens a sense of history, of the reality of the past, that is a very hard-won experience in our culture today. But here at OU, undergraduate students can walk through an open door and adopt one of these rare treasures for a semester research project. What good is it to preserve them forever by locking them away in a bank vault where no one will ever see them? The book is an irreplaceable object of art. It's a monument to civilization. How will we know those stories that give these books meaning unless students are able to see them?